everybody. I'm back once again. Today, I have a special guest with me, Veronica Falcon. She is one of the stars of the major blockbuster hit from this past weekend, Disney's Jungle Cruise. Veronica, thank you so much for your time. How are you?
Thank you. I'm good. Thank you for having me in your show.
First off, let's just start off. What have you felt from the reaction that viewers have gotten now that the movie has been out this first weekend? I know we had a lot of fun with it, and I hear the same thing from others.
Well, that's what I've heard. You know, I heard that everybody's really happy and kids are liking it and families, and the audience is really happy to go and watch this movie and they're enjoying it. And that's fantastic. You know, I think it's a great movie. You know, everybody loves, you know, it's a great mix because it has like adventure and it has like magic and it has laughs and it has great actors in it. And you know that Dwayne and Emily are really, really beloved stars by everybody, and rightfully so. And I'm just so happy to hear that the movie is doing so great.
Now you play a character, Trader Sam, who is very familiar to a lot of people who frequent Disneyland. Unfortunately, I'm not one of them. I can't afford it quite much. And so you have actually, I you know, pretty integral part in story and part of the storytelling. Do you want to tell us a little bit about your character?
Well, yes, my character is, I think it's quite phenomenal. First of all, she and Frank, they're really good friends. You know, they had a friendship in the history. If you read a little bit about the backstory of Trader Sam, or TS as it's known, there's a thing about immunity of aging. You know, it has a very extended lifespan. And I think that's where, you know, she and Frank became really close friends. They're both good-hearted people. You know, and Trader is a little bit ahead of her time. You know, she is the chief of the tribe, and she's also an inventor and a saleswoman. And then, you know, she has this very curious mind, and she has, if she has to be a warrior, she can be a warrior with her, you know, to defend her people and her, and the rainforest. And I think that's what makes her extraordinary, you know. It's a mix of all these things. And on top of that, she has this sense of wonder. You know, everything is fascinating to Trader. Even things that she's seen enough, like fruit in the jungle, you know, she still gets one fruit and looks at it and really savors it while she enjoys all the banter that's going on with Frank and Lily, you know. And at the same time, she's very wise, you know, she knows what's right, and she knows that Lily is really, she really wants to do the things because of the right reasons. So that's why she's supportive, and she really likes her. You know, I think Trader, the moment she sees Lily, she really, really likes her. You know, to see this woman like this doctor in pants and really like, you know, giving all this banter with Frank, I think Trader really, really empathizes with Lily.
I have to agree with you, because it seems like as soon as you guys have enough of a conversation, she's like, all right, this act is over. This is not the right, this is not the kind of person that we're going to.
I'm not going to do this for her. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Cause she's going to catch on. And I really like the fact that you brought up the character. She's really forward thinking as a chief of the tribe. She's not afraid to adapt and to take what comes to her, because yeah, the world's probably changing all around, but she wants to make sure to keep everybody safe. So yeah, that's fascinating.
It is, and the fact that it's a woman doing this character, I think Disney, you know, I'm very blessed that I got the role, but any woman that would have gotten the role would have been, I guess, equally happy to have such a version of Trader Sam, such a beloved character, you know. And the only thing was, I just wanted to do right by it. I just wanted to honor the character, because I respect very much the fans, the story. But I was having a blast just being Trader and being a woman, being Trader, you know.
I want to talk a little bit about that scene and where you guys get, you find that they're coming for the arrowhead. What are the differences? How is that shot, and how different is it from actually shooting it to see it on the screen? Because I know there's a lot of CGI and characters that need to be added in, but it was very, very exciting. I'm wondering what it was like for you to shoot it and then to see it on screen.
Well, not only that scene, I guess every single shot, like some have more CGI than others, you know. But at the end of the day, if the performance is not honest, if the performance is not grounded, then nothing is believable, you know. So you really have to be very grounded with your other actors and really play honestly and really believe what you're doing. You know, it's all a leap of faith, isn't it? Like we go and when you're performing it, you know, they can tell you, okay, here this snake is gonna come out, and here these bees are gonna come out or whatever. And you know, you are with the other actor, but you don't see it, or the same with the arrow, you know, like here it's gonna shine, or some magical light is coming or whatever, but you're not actually seeing it. So you really have to believe. But that's not any different than any other thing we do in acting. You know, you really have to believe in what your character is living and be very, very present in the moment. And I think that was very easy because everybody was so good. You know, like the whole set was perfect, the whole costume design was perfect, the makeup, you know, of course, all the actors, all the background actors were fantastic. You know, even the actors that you say, oh, nobody's gonna see this actor because he's so far away, they were totally, you know, determined to do the best they could, and they were working so hard, you know, and you can see that in the movie. And we all had moments when we had like a special effects that we knew they were coming, but everybody really believed. And then, you know, the magic of film happens and all this amazing post-production, and then you see it and it's even better than you imagined. Because I think it has the minds of so many creative people, and it just adds and adds and adds. So when you see it on the screen, there was a moment where I was totally into the movie. Like I didn't re I mean, I knew the script. I saw how the scene was shot. I was there, and I was really enjoying it, almost like like the audience, you know, like if I was part of the audience. And that for me speaks volumes of what they created, you know. Because you really get into it.
That's great to hear. Yeah, if everyone's buying into it on set, I'm sure that's very infectious.
Oh yes, very.
So where did you find your inspiration for Trader Sam? And I asked this because when I really enjoyed when you got to tell part of the lore, part of the story behind the arrowhead and what Lily had to do in order to complete her goal. And just the way you delivered it was almost like I kind of want to cross my feet down and sit on the ground and listen to this whole story. I think you even did a little bit better than The Rock did when he finished off his part of the story. Let me mention that.
Thank you. You know, Trader is a very wise woman, and she's a temporal. You know, she has a very extended lifespan, which means she's probably very, very wise, right? And she's very successful because not only she's the leader of a tribe, but she's in such a close commune to nature. And that, of course, fits your spirit. You know, everybody, whenever we go to nature, whatever we respect nature and enjoy it, like whether it's an animal or a plant or a forest or the ocean or whatever, we feel a little bit more human, a little bit more connected. And I think Trader is incredibly connected to all of this because of where she lives and because of her wisdom. And I remember, I come from Mexico, which is a beautiful country, and there's a lot of very ancient traditions, and there's a lot of very wise women and men that deal with you know, medicine with different ethnic groups. And you can hear, I've had the opportunity to work once with the Huichol Indians, you know, or with some Indians from the Sierra of Oaxaca, because of cultural exchanges that we did way in the past. And I remember some of the wise old men and women, the way they would tell stories to children, the way they would sit and really honor nature or whatever it is that they were doing. And they were a little bit of the inspiration for Trader, because I remember how they look and how they sounded and how wise they seem, you know, and they were. So I tried to take a little bit of that, and I hope I did a little. that.
And maybe that's why I like your character a little bit more is because of the fact that it did remind me a little bit of that. My dad's side of the family, they're from Nayarit. And so they've always been very, very proud to tell me stories and tell me about the Huicholes. I know that we had statues in our house growing up and things of that nature about some of the traditions and the storytelling. So yeah, it did come through to me. Now that you're mentioning that,
The indigenous communities, you know, they're so in tune with nature. They're so wise. They're so respectful of their environment and of everything. And I think we can learn a lot from that, you know?
Absolutely, I agree. I can't let you go without talking a little bit about one of your upcoming roles. See if you can tell me anything. I know you're going to be featured quite prominently in the final season of Netflix's Ozark. What can you tell me about that?
I can tell you that is one of the most joyous works I've ever had. And it's funny because the subject matter is very dark and difficult and complicated. But it's just working with you know, people like Laura Linney and Jason Bateman and everybody in the cast that I've met so far. They are so in love with what they do. They're so good at it. And at the same time, they're so generous, so respectful. I felt so welcome. You know, they've been doing this show incredibly successfully for 4 seasons, 3 seasons, I come in the fourth, and I felt welcome right away. I felt like they made me part of their Ozark family, and doing, you know, these scenes and the things, the way they're written, they're so beautifully written, so precise, and you wouldn't think, but I, you know, the show is very serious, and it has all these dark subject matters and all that, but while we're shooting, we're having such a good time. You know, it's just such a joy. Like, I've done scenes with Laura where I'm really laughing with her before we do the scene because we're talking about something else, and I could have coffee with her forever, but we're working, you know, and then we're like, okay, we have to work. And then she goes and she's amazing and she turns into this character, and that pulls you through. So it's a joy for me to be there. And I think the audience is really, really going to love this fourth season. The writing is impeccable. And there's a lot of amazing surprises and unexpected things that are going to happen, which of course I won't tell you.
But of course.
You guys are going to enjoy it very much. And it's just a joy to be part of it.
Well, I'm very much looking forward to it and looking forward to seeing your part as well.
Thank you.
Veronica, thank you so much for your time. I really appreciate it. Congratulations on your role as Trader Sam, and then also coming forward in the Ozark. I mean, heck, you've actually played quite an important role in Falcon and the Winter Soldier. I mean, it was kind of almost something as a memory, but still, it was a very, very important to Carly and what she did going forward.
So. Yes, you know, it was a lovely experience. We were in Prague shooting that. Unfortunately, when we were shooting, we haven't finished. I finished my part. I was going to be in 4 episodes. And I finished, and the day I finished at 7 p.m., I remember. And then they call me and they say, we need to get out of here, like, now. Like, so mm-hmm. At 9 o'clock, everybody, because, you know, COVID was happening. And mm-hmm. None of us, of course, could imagine how terrible this was going to be. But I remember this feeling of, is this really happening? And we're really like, they're closing the whole production. So, you know, they went back after a while and finished the series. And of course, they have to adapt and edit and reconstruct in a way the series. And I think they did a spectacular job. So my character, you know, instead of being 4 episodes, it's just 1 episode and it's a very tiny scene. But I totally agree with what they did. You know, they had to do the show and to make it work, and they did, absolutely. And the circumstances were extraordinary for all of us. You know, we're still dealing with this pandemic.
Yeah.
So anything they managed to do a wonderful show, and I had a great time doing it. I got to visit Prague. I got to be a little bit part of the Marvel Universe. And if I ever get to do that again, that'll be fantastic. And if not, it's still really good. And I think the show is doing very well, good as well, you know, but we all just trying to do the best with whatever it's happening. And we have to be supportive of one another. So yes, and I think the show is great. So
It's great. Great. Thank you for that tidbit on the show. I appreciate it. Oh, anytime I can learn any more about how things are made, especially some of my favorite shows, it always helps.
Good. I'm glad.
Again, Veronica, thank you so much. Thank you for your time. And hopefully I get to talk to you again soon.
Well, hopefully. Thank you and take care. And thank you for the interview.
Likewise. Bye-bye.